Seeing AI now has a new feature called Ask Seeing AI, which is similar to Be My Eyes' Be My AI and Ira's Access AI. This is an update video on Seeing AI. I talked about some of the newer AI features last week, but I actually recorded that video before the latest update of Seeing AI, where they added Ask Seeing AI. So welcome to another QAT video or quick accessibility tips. Let's go over Ask Seeing AI. Here I have my Pixel 8 Pro and I'm gonna launch Seeing AI, and I have a shortcut called button mapper where I just long press the volume up, but you can do it however you want to. Just go ahead and open Seeing AI.
Short text. Okay. Nappy Spring Kesnes PR COCASTL Spring 6 Dow Spring 1K824.
Let's point it up so that it stops reading. So now you want to go to the scene channel. You can navigate with your screen reader, but I'm going to swipe with one finger across the screen.
Document. Product. Scene. Preview.
And there we go. We're in scene, and now I'm going to capture an image.
Processing.
A drawing of a dog on a wall.
All right, so it says a drawing of a dog on the wall. I don't think my niece would be very happy with that description. It's actually a cat. Now we're going to go down to the bottom right. There is a more info button here.
Processing.
Takes a minute.
The image shows a wall and a desk with various items. On the wall, there are two pieces of paper attached. The upper paper features a drawing of a cat with the words Auntie then written above it and the date April 3rd, 2029 in the top right corner. Below this drawing, there is another piece of paper with the words Happy Spring written in a stylized manner, accompanied by a drawing of flowers and trees. On the desk, there are two postcards or photographs lying flat. The one closest to the edge of the desk has the words Kure Beach Pier with an image of a building that resembles a pier entrance. The other postcard or photograph, partially underneath the first, shows an image of a castle. To the right of these postcards, there is a round, decorative object with a colorful, intricate design. Next to these items, there is a blue, portable speaker with buttons on the top, positioned horizontally. The speaker is near the edge of the desk, and to its left, there is a small, white, circular object that appears to be a cable or wire holder adhered to the desk surface. The desk extends beyond the frame of the image, and the wall above the desk meets the desk at a right angle. The lighting in the room casts a shadow on the wall, slightly obscuring the lower part of the Happy Spring paper.
But now, at the bottom, we have a share button, and then at the bottom right, we have an Ask Seeing AI button. So I'm going to go ahead and tap on that. Now it kind of looks like a chat, and it shows the previous answer, and at the bottom we have an edit field. So now you can go there and we can type in, describe the cards on the wall. And we'll send that over and we'll wait and see what it says.
The image shows two cards displayed on a wall. The upper card features a drawing of a red fox lying down with the text Auntie then written above it. The date April 3rd, 2029 is noted in the top right corner. Below this card is another that reads Happy Spring in a playful, handwritten style with a drawing of a tree, flowers, and what appears to be a sun or a flower in the sky. The colors used in this card are primarily green, pink, and blue.
Okay, so it didn't really give much more information about it. Let's ask about the speaker. Describe the speaker.
The speaker in the picture is a portable Bluetooth speaker. It's placed on a dark surface, likely a desk or a shelf. To the right side of the image, the speaker is rectangular with rounded edges and appears to be in a horizontal orientation. It has a dark grill covering the front, with the brand's logo towards the lower right corner. On the top of the speaker, there are control buttons that are likely used for power, volume adjustment, and Bluetooth connectivity. The speaker has a modern and compact design, suitable for easy transportation and use in various locations.
Explain the button layout of the speaker. Let's try that.
The speaker in the picture is a portable Bluetooth speaker, and it has a series of buttons on the top surface for various functions. From left to right, the button layout is as follows. 1. The first button on the left appears to be the power button, used to turn the speaker on or off to. Next to the power button, there is a Bluetooth pairing button, which is typically used to connect the speaker to a Bluetooth-enabled device. 3. The third button from the left is the play pause button, which can be used to play or pause the audio that is being streamed to the speaker for. Following the play pause button, there are two buttons that seem to be volume controls. The one on the left is likely the volume down button, and the one on the right is the volume up button. These buttons are standard on many Bluetooth speakers and are designed to be user-friendly for controlling the device's functions.
That it did not get right, but it's also obscured by my mic stand. Let's try one more time and go back and take a different picture. You have to press back quite a few times.
Process a blue speaker on a table.
There we go. Let's ask now.
Processing.
It just confidently makes
the image shows
up.
A portable speaker placed on a wooden surface. The speaker is predominantly black with a light blue accent around its perimeter. On the top surface of the speaker, there are control buttons including power, Bluetooth connectivity, volume down, play pause, volume up, and a bass button. The brand sound core is visible on the right side of the speaker's top surface. The front of the speaker has a metal grille with a musical note design on the lower right corner. To the left of the speaker, there is a small white circular object, possibly a charger or a cable organizer. Behind the speaker, there is a coaster with a colorful, intricate design, and a photograph with a white border is partially visible, showing an image of a building under a sky with clouds. The photo is leaning against a vertical surface, which is not fully visible in the image. The coaster and the photograph are both placed closer to the edge of the wooden surface than the speaker.
Okay, now it knows that it's a coaster. Interesting. All right, so I'm going to hit the Ask Seeing AI button. And we'll just ask one last question. Explain the button layout of the speaker. Right, let's send it.
The speaker in the picture has a series of control buttons on its top surface. From left to right, the first button appears to be the power button, indicated by the universal power symbol. Next to it, there is a Bluetooth pairing button, denoted by the Bluetooth symbol. Following that, there is a button with a minus sign, which is typically used to decrease volume. In the center, there is a play pause button, which is often used to control audio playback. To the right of the play pause button, there is a plus sign button, which is commonly used to increase volume. The last button on the right seems to be a bass boost button, as it has the word bass above it and a symbol that suggests an enhancement of sound.
It totally got that wrong. It's supposed to be power, then Bluetooth, then the bass boost, and then decrease volume, play and pause, and increase volume. This pretty much behaves very similar to all the AIs out there. It confidently shares what it thinks is right, even if it makes things up, or sometimes, you know, it might think something's one thing one time and then something else another time. Like the cat, the picture of a cat my niece drew, it's a cat, it's not a fox, and it's neither is it a dog. So it's just like every AI right now, honestly, where it's just not that accurate, but it's accurate enough to be helpful a lot of the time. In my previous video from last week where I talked about the AI in the document mode, I talked about how I wish it was available in the scene descriptions, and it looks like they listened to me even before I put out the video. Well, no, it probably had nothing to do with me, really. Everybody's doing it, so I guess Microsoft decided to jump on board. I honestly really like how they did it. It speaks it aloud. Unlike Be My AI and Ira's Access AI Plus, it has a dark mode, which Be My AI still doesn't have on the Android side. It's just a pretty clean layout, though for me, I find that it's not always super efficient because you have to take a picture, then you have to go to more info, then you have to go to Ask Seeing AI, and then you have to go back a few times to like take another picture. So, but for me, as somebody who doesn't always use TalkBack or a screen reader, it is super, super helpful to just have it read aloud to me. And that's what I've been asking Be My Eyes and Ira to do, and hopefully they get on board with that. I also noticed that they fixed the text for both the document chat as well as the new Ask Seeing AI feature. Unlike before, it was black text on a gray background. Now it is white text on a gray background when the Seeing AI responds, which is really, really great. And honestly, I know there's a lot of apps out there. This is the one that I gravitate to because it's just, it just has everything, and I don't necessarily have the time or the inclination to go and open apps and try this one. No, let me try the other one. No, actually, for this type of thing, I want to use this other app. And for me, I just want to have one app that can do it all. Maybe it doesn't do everything perfectly, but it gets the job done most of the time. And for the record, I do like trying out different apps. I love it. I mean, that's what I'm here for. That's what I do on this channel. I try out different apps. I try out different products. But when I actually need to use something, unless I'm trying to review something and test something out, Seeing AI is the one that I end up using. It's the one that I have the shortcut set to. It has so many different modes, and if you don't use those modes, you can always hide the ones you don't use. I think it's a fantastic app, and I think it just keeps getting better. This is not sponsored, though. Microsoft, you know, if you're interested, I'm totally open to discussing that. But that's it for now. If you use these AI features, Be My AI, Access AI from Myra, or now Ask Seeing AI, let me know. Which one do you like best? Also, let me know if you're interested in a comparison video between all the different AI apps. If you want to support the channel and what I do, and get some exclusive perks, consider becoming a Patreon or YouTube channel member. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're interested in more videos about accessibility and assistive technology. Thanks everybody for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. So, which is really, really great. Bless you. Now let's try that again. Okay, I'm just glad it didn't mention any marks on the wall this time.
Yay, I think I was successful in hiding the marks with the kids' artwork. And if you're not sure what I'm talking about, I did a video on Access AI and the AI was telling me about marks on my wall. Oh, and also there were no elusive helicopters like in Be My AI.